the person that God is sending, I know you hear me, but I need you to listen. The person that God is going to send, who is going to love you for the rest of your life and love you exactly as you are and as you grow and change, is going to love you so much that you forget what love never was. Let's get into it. I want to preface this. You need to stop looking. Stop looking for the one. Stop looking for your person. You need to start looking for yourself. And if you already know who you are, double down on that. There's no limit or point where you're just like, I know myself enough where I can just stop. No, the self-awareness journey, the self-development journey is a forever ongoing journey where you're constantly unraveling layers within yourself. The best way I could describe the self-awareness kind of journey is like, self-awareness is when you take yourself out of your own jar and you read your own label. And there's a plethora of ingredients that you're reading. Good, bad, ugly, beautiful, you name it. And you never get to a point where you're just like, ah, I've read the entire label. As years go on, as trials and tribulations, as you grow, as you are just open to different experiences and perspectives, you get to a point where you just learn something more and new and deeper about yourself as time moves forward. So remember this. As you continue to work on yourself, at some point God is going to notice and say, they're ready. Send them. Send them their person. Send them the person that I crafted for them before they even came into this world. The person that was meant for them, their person. God will do that as you remain obedient, as you remain on your journey, on your path, and focus on yourself. And trust and believe that. That's what faith is. It's taking that step when you don't see the entire staircase. Realizing that when it's all said and done, everything's going to unravel and play out exactly how it's supposed to. You might be in a season of heartbreak, but there's a lesson in it. And if you keep finding yourself going through the same thing over and over and over again, remember this. I'm going to share this with you. God will put you through the same experience, through the same tests, through the same lessons over and over and over again with a different face, a different person, or a different environment until you learned the lesson in it. And if you keep praying to God for your current season to change, and it hasn't changed, and you believe God is who he says he is, then know that there is great power in the season that you're currently in. I know you heard me, but I pray that you're listening, because this is real life. This is truth. Focus on your own growth. Focus on your own growth. That control what you can control. And the only thing that you can control in this life for certain is yourself, your attitude, your perspective, your actions, the story you tell yourself, your own self-development. Focus on those aspects within yourself. Build your faith, pray, remain obedient, do the best that you possibly could with the things that are immediately in your control. And the things that you can't control, let God control it. Relinquish it. Let it go. Accept it for what it is. And that's the only way you will ultimately find happiness and peace. There's no secret. That's the only secret, to be honest. That is the only recipe in order to find happiness and peace, regardless of what is going on around you. Things that are just going not in your favor, that are going off script, away from the story that you initially imagined. Finding a way to accept it. Finding a positive way to look at it. If they walked out of your life, then you dodged a bullet. They lost you. You need to make sure that you love yourself first. Because how do you expect to love somebody if you don't even know how to love yourself? And let go of searching. Release just trying to find your person or the one. Like I said before, and I'm going to reiterate, focus on finding yourself on the deepest level. You're never going to get to a point where you know yourself completely. every year I've been on this journey of self-development, I'm learning so many more different depth and layers of myself, and it's so beautiful. I am more of my own best friend today than I was a year ago. And that's what it is all about. God is the powerful force that brings healing. He is the ultimate healer. And realize that, you know, people that you might have held on to in your life, you need to learn to let go and let God. It's not your job to fix people. It's not your job to force people to be in your life. Nor is it your job to turn your backs on people. It's your job to just control what you can control and let God control what you can't. And recognize the fact that you might think you know what's best for the people around you, but sometimes there are things that God knows and you don't. You only see a fragment of what a person's going through. God knows the full picture. He sees the full picture. So he has the full recipe and the remedy that's required to help them deal with whatever traumatic experience that they're dealing with, or the things that they have to go through on their own or alongside him. So just learn to let go and let God, and realize that your person is coming. And when they do come, like I said before, they're going to love you so hard. They're going to love you so much that you forget what love never was. And you will be so grateful for them. Believe me, I'm just so happy. Like, my person isn't in my life yet. I know they're coming, but I'm just so excited because I know what I have to bring and offer. And I know that that person is going to have the same exact energy and love and compassion and understanding and patience that I have. The way I'm feeling right now is like they're already here before they even entered my life. That's how you're supposed to do it. Be the person before you are the person, before you attract that person. Anyways, just want to say thank you so much for just listening to this powerful message. And if there's something that just stuck out to you, that resonated with you, that you learned, or that just really hit home, leave a comment below. Share. And please hit the subscribe button, the like button, just for your support and help me grow. This is such a beautiful journey, just being able to create videos and messages in this atmosphere is just such a fortunate blessing. So I just want to say thank you so much for your support, for making it this far in the video and watching. Without further ado, peace from Deez, and I hope you have a better rest of your day.